let me see your back real quick.
Oh yeah.
Dude, man, tight. I know. That's super cool.
It is 7 in the morning. It is really cold, but we're still gonna paint.
And it's snowing too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's snowing out there.
Yeah. Right, tell me your name and what you do with AAA.
Connor Marquette. I've been a sign painter for 6 years. Currently own the company. Took over the company about 2 years ago. Started as an apprentice.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, my name's Connor. Been a sign painter for 6 years. Currently own the company. Took it over about 2 years ago. We specialize in traditional murals. Sign painting, gold leaf on glass, pinstriping, all the good stuff.
Why don't we just start off, what are you guys doing?
I'm trying to make sure I didn't forget anything. That's a common fear here.
Yeah.
Get all the way down there, and then we are missing something. That's bad.
Bad time waiting to happen.
But actually, I think we're good. I think now we're gonna pull the truck out, and then get the scissor lift put on the trailer, and then double check we got everything, and then I think we're good to go.
After this, what's going on? You're just driving over there now?
Yeah.
Okay. They're out there in the cold. It's 26 degrees outside. Jesus Christ, bro. And they're out there. What time is it? It's 7 in the morning, but we've been filming for a little bit. Going on?
Well, use that GoPro, I got some good footage.
Yeah, thank you. Look at this thing go.
Okay, so we're at the place. We're at 11th and Main Street. This is the wall. This is a historic wall that there's just been a lot of paintings and murals on this wall, and we'll get into that later. It's like 20 something degrees outside, so
yeah. I'm just following you around.
Good. I'm just getting used to it. Every time I turn around, I'm like, oh.
It's like being on a TV show.
No, dude, I didn't think that we'd get this famous this fast.
Just start talking and like just say whatever you want.
I don't really say much in this process.
That's okay. the main point here is just to capture what's genuine.
Yeah. We're thinking too that if need be, because I was talking to Alex, we were talking about this last night, and sometimes it's hard for us to talk about what we're doing when we're doing it. But after we've done it, it's easy.
We could do like a voiceover afterwards.
Yeah.
And that way, you know, it'll be good.
Yeah. Usually when we're talking, we're so hyper-focused and vigilant, we're just right in the zone.
Yeah. Because I'm documentarying this thing for them,
yeah.
And then we're going to collaborate together, get some photos and videos, so yeah.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah, that would be super cool. Oh, you still think you're going to be able to fly the drone?
Oh yeah, we could fly the drone for sure.
Oh, sweet. Yeah.
So why don't we start off with your name and what you do here?
My name is Ryan Solomon and I work and own Belmont Barbershop.
So I was doing some research on the barbershop and this used to be like a cigar or tobacco place?
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
Yeah, the building was built in around like 1895.
Wow.
And it started out as like a kind of grocery store. It was like a tailor in here. It's kind of just a catch-all.
Uh-huh.
But it was the first building on this like end of town. So it was just kind of a standalone building over here, dirt roads out front. And then around 1910 or 1911, Ed Salmon moved his cigar store in here, Salmon Cigar, and John Hannafin worked for Ed Salmon.
Mm-hmm.
I think Hannafin started working for Salmon when he was 12 years old.
Yeah.
And it was Salmon Cigar for those first few years. Ed Salmon got sick and went back to France where he was from.
Wow.
And John Hannafin just kind of kept running the place.
Mm-hmm.
And then around like 1920,
John's brother came to work for him, and that's when they kind of switched the name from Salmon Cigar to Hannafin Cigar. Ed Salmon passed away when he was in France. He was sick, went back home, and passed away, and so Hannafin just kind of took over the place, and then, yeah, switched it over to Hannafin Cigar in the 20s, and then the two brothers ran it up until, like, the late 60s.
So what happened between 1960 to today?
This is what you need. This is a good one, too. That's nice. That's nice salt. Yeah?
Rocking.
Hell yeah.
What got you into sign making, sign painting?
So I've always loved large scale artwork, but it was hard to be a painter and make a living. And so I stumbled upon a sign shop one night when I was walking through the neighborhood, and luckily was able to get an apprenticeship there.
You're from Boise, right?
Yeah, I'm from Boise. Yeah, born and raised.
And so I remember you telling me you heard this guy who was playing vinyls and you just wanted to help him out, right?
Yep.
Tell me more about that.
So his name was Mike Miller, and I was just walking by, and at that point in time, the business had been closed down for a couple of years because the original owner had passed away. And so Mike was in the process of cleaning out the building and restarting the company. And so I just started by cleaning. I just started by cleaning and sweeping. Yeah.
So since the business was closed down, who was running the company?
No one, after he passed away.
No one?
It was shut down for a couple of years. Yeah, so actually it wasn't me. So it was Mike Miller who originally restarted the company and then hired all the painters and whatnot. And Sean was working there, Sean Severid, our current graphic designer. Ooh, I just like fall out of the frame. Current graphic designer. Yeah. And so I was lucky enough to get an apprentice under him and some other painters that were working there at the time. And then it was actually kind of circumstance how I climbed the ladder.
Yeah, how did you?
Mainly because.
How did you get the company and not
yeah.
Sean?
Well, Sean was in New York a various couple of times, but that's kind of part of the circumstance. Like, people would end up getting fired or not pulling through, or they're late and I wasn't, and it's simple as that. You know, I held consistency in the company.
Did you have like a certain hunger?
Oh yeah. As soon as I knew it was something that I could do and do well, and that I'd be doing what I love doing every day, I just went for it 100%. And I dropped everything else.
So you earned it.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, it was a lot of blood, sweat, and tears for sure.
So yeah, like you put your heart and soul into this.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
No, and everyone that we do too, we put it. We try. I mean, you see the stress level that we all carry.
When we
start a piece, you know, it's like the level of intensity, because we can feel every bit of what we're about to put up. We can feel all that, and knowing what can go wrong and what can go right and exactly how to do it. And that's where the stress comes in.
Tell me about the synergy of your team.
We got an awesome team. And if they weren't so awesome, we would not be able to do the things we do. Just like this piece that we're doing here today. We wouldn't be able to do that in a day because people would be working slow or putting stuff off or having someone else try to clean up after them. Whereas everybody here kind of pulls their weight. I've always tried to go off of working with people's strong suits and what they do best. So if you're a great illustrator, then we try to put you on the illustration work. If you're great at lettering, then we try to put you on the lettering work. You know, whatever you're more comfortable with. If you hate heights, obviously I'm not gonna put you on a scissor lift. But I might try. I might try to get you on a scissor lift, but you know, so yeah.
What, I'll wait for this truck. Where do you see the future of AAA Sign Co. going?
Oh, AAA Sign Co. We're on the modern frontier of traditional signage. In the next 5 to 10 years, I plan on expanding to our own, very own location, potentially a team of 15 to 20 people. Full sign production, mural work. I want us to get international recognition. And travel and work with various communities. Because part of it is we're not in it for necessarily the money or the notoriety, but we also really like helping the businesses that we work for.
Yeah.
And seeing a customer that's extremely happy with the work that we've done, and then continuing to see that sign or mural or whatever we've done for them bring people to them and bring them more work and support their business, I think that's where it really hits home for all of us.
Just can't keep up. Snap it, pistol in your face. I'm gonna let some graveyard lord be her resting place. Woman, I'm trouble, I be all worried mine.
Traditionally, I was taught to draw all of our letters. As you can see, we've combined traditional drawing letters with modern day graphic design. So we actually do have a graphic designer on staff who does the digital design. And then we come through and then combine it with the traditional techniques. So that way we produce some really nice work.
I don't know what else to ask.
You're good, dude. Usually, I think that's like, you nailed it.
How many interviews have you had?
Actually, I've done quite a few for magazines. And then I've done a couple of film interviews. But most of the time people are just filming me painting. Usually they don't ask me questions. I'm more used to just talking to people trying to get business and interacting with people and trying to figure out what they need. And that's kind
of
how.
Man, it sounds like this piece is going to be more of like a historical accent piece, I feel.
You're creating history.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
I love it. And I am very proud when we get to go see paintings that we did years ago and they still look great. And I'm very proud when I get to go through and refinish paintings that were painted by the sign painter that started the shop in 1944. I get to go touch up his work and continue those signs. So it's good. It's awesome.
Well, now, all in my sleep, hear my doorbell ring. Looking for my baby, I didn't see not a doggone thing. Woman, I was gone, I was gone good now. Well, honey, I could never be satisfied, and I just couldn't keep up. Little baby, she gon' jump and shout. That old train be late, man, Lord, and I come on. I be trouble, I be all good. Well, honey, ain't no way to work for me, be shot, and I just can't keep up.
Documentating?
All right, how do you feel? You finished?
Fantastic.
Finished the mural.
It's great. Everything went according to plan. We got a brief little glimpse of sunshine there for a minute. You know, got some sunlight on us while we were putting the last strokes down. I think everything turned out great. Went according to plan.
I woke up this morning. Yes, poor lightning, show us, please. Whoa, I woke up this morning. Yes, poor lightning, show us, please. Whoa, I heard somebody calling. That was my little girl calling me. She called kind of lonesome, she said. Thank you. She the lightning, oh lightning. Darling, do you know something keeps on worrying me?